Konnichiwa. Hello, my name is Evan, and I'm here to talk to you about my love for anime, Japanese animation. Yes, sir. Anyway, so today's video is going to be a little bit shorter because the last video was a lot longer, but please don't let that like tempt you to not go and watch it because I worked very hard on that video. Like, that was like my first serious time trying to like edit something, and I did it all on my phone, which was like not easy. So yeah, if you have not, if you would like, please go and check the video out. I talk about some animes on my anime list, and you know, yeah. So go ahead and try and give it a watch. Anyway, before I get started on this video, please make sure that you like and subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll know when I post another video. And yeah, so let's get started. Okay, so today I wanted to talk about Eden Zero. So they, like, if you haven't heard of Eden Zero, it's a manga by Mashima Hiro, the same person who made Fairy Tail. And yes, so they recently aired 2 episodes of the anime. They aired it early, so they're supposed to release it on the 11th, April 11th, but they did like a pre-airing or something, I guess, in Japan. I'm really not sure, but they aired like the first 2 episodes on YouTube, so yeah, it's kind of cool. They had them, yeah, so if you want to watch it, go ahead and watch it. But I wanted to talk about it and talk about some of the differences between, well, not really talk about the differences between them. I wanted to share my thoughts on it and also like talk about how like it sets itself apart from Fairy Tail. Anyway, so yeah, let's start. I don't know what I just said. Okay, so Eden Zero is basically like about these 2 people. A girl's name is Rebecca and Shiki, the 2 characters, Rebecca and Shiki. So Rebecca reminds me of Lucy, I don't know. It's just, I kind of wish that he would have made her have like, I don't know, brown or blonde, like not blonde, brown or red hair or something, so it wouldn't have any similarities to like Lucy, but she reminds me of Lucy. And also, he has happies in this show, which is like, wow. Like, cause you know how, I don't know if you know this show, you're like really like into anime. Like, there's a show that Mashima Hiro made, it's called Rave Master, and I remember watching the show, and I read a little bit of the manga too, but there's this, you know, the character Plue, he's like supposed to be a dog, he does not look like a dog, he's not a dog, I don't know what he is, he just does, anyway. He makes an appearance in Fairy Tail, of course, and you know how he does, like Mashima Hiro does. He puts little Easter eggs in like his shows from past shows, and he puts them in his like newer shows. So that's what he did with Happy, of course. So Happy is in this show and manga. So yeah, so and then the, like I said, Shiki, right? Rebecca and Shiki. Shiki reminds us, his personality reminds me of Natsu, but like. In terms of like looks, he like kind of like, I don't know if people said this, but he's like the love child of Gray and Natsu. if that makes sense to you, that's what he reminds me of. It's like the love child of oh my god, I was about to say Naruto. No, 2 totally different shows, Natsu and Gray. Anyway, so Rebecca finds Shiki on this like island of robots. It's like an amusement park or whatever. And Shiki's like the only human there. And he considers all like the robots his friends and whatever. But anyway, besides that, he leaves that island and he wants to travel through space to like, and he wants to find like 100 friends in space or something. But the whole premise of the show, or the manga in general, is that they're trying to find this mysterious, like, spirit or person, I don't know. Her name is Mother, and she has the ability to grant you any wish. So that's basically what the show is about. They try to like find her, and yeah, and like I said, he puts some Easter eggs in there. Like on the first two episodes, if you look closely and pay attention, you'll see Levy and you'll see one of the girls from Mermaid Teal from like the Magic Games arc from Fairy Tail. So you gotta pay attention though, cause like, I mean, it only took me a second to figure that out though. Like literally, like I was like, is that Levy? I was like, it is Levy. Anyway, there's also a character in there that kind of resembles Urza. Kinda, she does. She's like literally Urza, but with like an eye patch. Her name is Elsie in the manga. So yeah, the only thing that I don't like about it is like, it has like the same like trope, like the whole friendship thing where like friendship conquers everything. And you know, when they're like in their lowest point or when they're like about to die, it's like, as long as I have friends, anything is possible. You know, that whole trope, it's kind of annoying and like irritating because like, come on. I get it, friendship is a powerful thing, but it's like, friendship can't conquer death. Like, dude, that's like, if that were possible, we'd all be alive. It's some like, if we had like real friends, we'd all be alive. We'd all be like be able to resurrect ourselves. But yeah, that's the only thing that I don't like about it, and that's what's kind of similar between Fairy Tail and Eden Zero. That's like the similarity, is that the friendship thing, like, you know, it's just, it conquers everything. It defeats death. But other than that, the whole like it sets itself apart from Fairy Tail in like a really good way, and I like it. But you know, that's just my personal opinion. I just want to know what you guys think about it, and you know, just let me know in the comments, you know, and just, you know, yeah, let me know what you think of the manga and the show, because like, I haven't read like all of the manga. I have a few chapters that I have to catch up on. It's like 136 chapters so far, and I'm on like 118, but I'm gonna be catching up soon. So yeah, anyway, thank you guys for watching this video, and again, make sure to like, subscribe down below, and I'll see you next time.